saying, he's telling me to eat. He's telling me to eat these grasshoppers. Personally, I can't eat, but let him just try. I saw him try. Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. In case you're new here, hi, my name is Frasha and welcome to the Dream Team. So welcome again to yet another episode in Kampala City, where we are going to have a walking tour throughout the Kampala City. So I hope you guys will enjoy this as I am about to enjoy. We'll be having the best tour guide with the best company ever. I'll let you guys see him after or throughout the tour, and he will get to explain himself and explain his company. So you guys, you should sit down and be ready for this. Okay, so let's head to the city.
In 1890, and it was established as a result of trade between Arab and Indian traders who were coming to Africa and trading with the local people. So they would bring spices, they would bring garments, and the chiefs and the kings in Uganda were interested in those products, so they'll exchange with them.
Oh, like it was butter trade, something to something.
Exactly. So they give them curry shells, they give them what, then in exchange, these guys would give them also certain resources like minerals, like gold, and what. And then from there, it grew up and became a great market.
Yeah, it's a really huge market. So now it majors on food.
Major product is food and household items. If you sit down there, you'll see
household
items. Yeah. But for many people, it's like the prime destination for food, fresh food, fresh vegetable. And the prices here are cheaper than you can find anywhere else. So that section there is over there. Chicken.
So like it is the oldest, okay, let's start. Oldest market in Kampala.
Established 1890. That building down there was built in 1927.
The one in red?
The one in red. You can see the market there. So they built it when the market had started growing. It has not been changed ever since that time.
And the name is still the same?
The name came to be established in the early 1990s. I mean 1900s.
The name is?
Around 1903. Nakasero Market.
Nakasero Market. Yeah. Okay.
Before that was just an open field. None of these buildings. Then as time went on, it started developing.
Being busy. I know it has developed, like this most places, the buildings are new.
Are very new. Yeah. So now everyone in Kampala who owns a restaurant or who plans on buying food for home, buys their vegetables and food.
Like in bulk, it's cheaper bulk.
It's much, much cheaper.
Okay.
10,000 shillings or 10,000 shillings can go with the
Okay.
So it's very big, so we walk through and we go through and then we go down that side.
Okay. So guys, this is the busiest food market in Uganda. And the name, I keep forgetting.
Nakasero Market.
Nakasero Market. Yeah. So let's head inside and see what they have inside.
Yeah.
Okay.
Some are far away, like in western Uganda. Obviously, when they bring them here, the price increases a bit. So.
And you have like greenhouses food?
We have?
Like greenhouse food, and then they bring them here?
No, we don't have those. Yeah? Like GMOs.
Yeah.
No. This is
110%.
Okay.
Sorry.
So,
and they are very fresh.
So fresh.
Yeah. Surprising, we just came to the market and this guy is telling me to eat. He's telling me to eat these grasshoppers. Personally, I can't eat, but let him just try. I saw him try and let him eat. You want?
No, it's okay.
Why?
I buy from there because they're expensive.
Okay.
Getting them is very hard.
So oh gosh, these are real grasshoppers.
Yeah.
I don't think I can eat. I can't even try. It's a delicacy in Uganda. He's saying
real
that.
Food, real food.
Yeah. I cannot eat. I can't help myself. I can't. was our tour guide throughout the tour, and introduce yourself.
My name is Arthur. I work with the MASH in Uganda, and I do walking tours in and around Kampala. And if you want to get to immerse yourself into the culture around the city, you see some highlights, important monuments, then be sure that we're giving the best trip. And we have our platform on TripAdvisor, so just go on TripAdvisor and search for Kampala walking tours. And the 3-hour optional trip to Gaddafi Mosque, and you'll see the reviews and know for yourself what kind of service you offer.
Yes, I'm telling you, they are just the best. I got the best tour, and I toured all Kampala, and I feel like that was not just enough. I wish we had more time together.
Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you so much for your time, and
yeah,
also for spending the day with me. I really enjoyed it. Yeah. God bless you.
Bye-bye.
So, I hope you guys enjoyed the tour, and there is one thing I'll mention. We went to very many different monuments in the Kampala city, but there were some places where we were not allowed to record, so that is why I did not include everything. Most of the part, it was like the market, because that is a public area. There were also many different monuments that we went, but I never recorded him and I never recorded anything, but I just took pictures where you should follow my Instagram page and you'll find the pictures there. So hope you enjoyed it. Until the next vlog, still in Uganda, stay tuned in. I love you. Subscribe if you've not yet.